I'm Jorge Arruego. I'm the PM 11 production manager. The assessment of the breaks with the old system, let's say that it was sometimes really, really difficult. When we were trying to push the speed in order to increase the production, we face a situation that we don't know anymore where those breaks were coming. So in order to carry on pushing the production limits, you need information, because with the right information, you can take the right decisions and then do what is really, really needed in order to overcome and keep pushing those limits. And that's why we went for the new brake camera system. We considering different suppliers, but also something that we were looking as well is the internal feedback in the Saica organization, because recently there has been another upgrade in the organization in the brake camera system. So we were looking what they have been done and what this is bringing, and we saw that the Procemex have not been that has been implemented in other machines. We saw the quality that it was that they were getting, how satisfied they were, and that and we saw that it met what we were looking for. Based on the others' experience, when you have to, like internally in the group, when you have to think that they are pretty similar, we just decided to go to the none that has been successful in other mills of the group. So that's what we did. The main reason is that it was given all that we were that we would need, like a very clear image. Certain speeds you need to see, be able to see the defect. Easy of usage, but mainly quality of the videos and the synchronization, relatively maintenance free, as we were told from the show. That's because okay, when you go to buy one of those things, everybody's going to be saying that it's maintenance free, but my past experience with the system that we have here and with other systems that I've been using, so I've been working across my life with different suppliers, the brake camera system is something like is quite maintenance consuming. Okay, and you need to keep really, really on top of it in order to have like in very good conditions. And okay, we have a mill similar to this one, producing the similar paper than we are, and with the similar speed, that they were able to tell us that you basically install and not forget, but the equipment is reliable and it was meeting the expectations in regards of like quality, how they synchronize between the cameras, easy of use for the operators, easy to identify the brakes due to the quality of the information received. So that's why we went for it. So the time spent beforehand on planning the job and what we really want to do it, to have like a previous visit with the person responsible of the installation, that he was the same person that later on came here to install. He was able to understand exactly what we need, what we were looking for, so we could be defining really, really well, working not only with the maintenance team, if not as well with the production team. So what do you really want to see in each one of the positions? That helped a lot at the time during the installation, that basically when we start to watch the pictures, that immediately it was what we have in our minds, that I was really, really satisfied in terms of the training as well, the commitment of the installation engineer. Better to be a little bit patient, or like we said in Spain, that only thieves and bad bullfighters rush. So we didn't rush, so we are not bullfighters, nor we are not thieves, so that's why we succeed, I would say. We have increased the average speed of the paper machine quite a lot. We have reduced the number of breaks in the paper machine, and well, the best result is that we installed the brake camera system in September. In January, in December, we hit our gross production record absolute since the startup, and in January we hit it again, and the net production as well. We choose the installation on like what we have like a quite a long shutdown. And then they are installed the equipment that we have to install during the shutdown, but part of the system was installed meanwhile we were running as well. So that made like that from the point that we started to have the system running, it was really, really, I think that we stay without any brake camera I would say six or eight hours only. It was very tiny amount of time. The impact of the web inspection, I would say that has been even bigger because, for example, in one of the bottlenecks as well that we have, apart from the brakes on the paper machine, that it was the winder, because we have only one winder to follow a high-speed paper machine. So the efficiency of the winder has to be really, really high. So those unknown defects that you have on the paper that they will cause a break at the winder, they were adding time that the winder not producing. And they say that we move from like an average of 4-5 breaks per day at the winder for unknown reasons, to currently that we are in 1-1.5 breaks per day. So it has boosted the spare capacity of the winder, but also for this break solving is helping, because first it's integrated with the camera system, so it's very handy to, okay, if I have a defect here, to track back on the process where it is. And second, it allows to the winder people to get that sample, so you physically are able to see a defect that was suspecting, okay, that could be the root cause of my breaks, but the defect it has not been that big that it has no break at the paper machine. But in the winder it will have done, but you have been able to stop and get the defect. What you got? You save the break at the winder, but also you get the information, and looking the paper and the defect itself, it's much, much easier to identify your point of problem. Let's say, like, for example, we were getting defects where we have a slime in one of the sides. So which side is this one? It's top, bottom, wire. So, well, so then you reduce the area that you have to be looking in the paper machine where it is coming to just very narrow area. Meanwhile, in the past, where you're having, okay, we have a break. What we have seen in the winder? Hole. And then you have to start to, but the hole could be coming in a paper machine that is that long, could be coming plenty of space, it could be coming from the side, set after dryers, very dryers, press section, forming section. So basically you have to be looking after the whole thing. So what you do? Okay, let's start split the resources, and you look at this, but not everybody's looking at the same thing. Meanwhile, this one, you are, in a question of minutes, you are narrowing the area, but you have to be looking to a very, 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 very tiny amount of area, and it's much, much easier. I'm not going to say that every time we are going to find out where they are coming, because it's not possible, but in a high percentage, if you have the paper making knowledge, you can just nail the area, and this is what we have done. At the moment, we are still keeping contact with Procemex, because still we are facing like some little issues from time to time, but so far, the response has been good. I mean, it's still like totally support.